Are we working? Oh yeah, it's working. Hello everybody, it's Chris here from Complete TV, better known as CTV. So, been looking forward to this one, quite excited. I'm going to be giving you a little bit of a review on the Bazooka goals. So, we purchased 10 of these last year. So it was sort of at the start point of the lockdown, sort of like February time, or was it May? Can't really remember, but we purchased 10 of them. Now the reason why we got these Bazooka goals was because we were traditionally using like those sort of flimsy, sort of like pug goal sort of things that like you could blow them over, like. Like just blow away, so they didn't really have that sort of weight that we needed in the sessions. Now we do a lot of our sessions on like 3G and stuff like that, so we needed to make sure that we had something that was actually going to stay there and not just be blown away in the wind. So I've sort of known about Bazooka goals for quite some time now. I was always just really scared because I thought they were going to be super expensive, and for someone like me with the Academy program that we're running, I like to brand things up, and Bazooka do like great deals on being able to brand up your goals to however you want.
That's rad.
So we got 10 of these all branded up with our logo printed on the back, which is super cool. And yeah, I mean, we've enjoyed using them. And I think the biggest thing for us is sometimes time's against us when we're setting up sessions. So these are like really good for like setting up quickly, and we, our curriculum and our philosophy and our sort of what we do is we want to try and do a lot of like small-sided games, so they're the perfect size. So you know, like 1v1s, 2v2s, 3v3s, even like a sort of like a pre-warm-up just to get all of our sort of Academy players into these small-sided games straight away. It just works really well. We've invested in these, and you know, it's been brilliant. Now we have had a couple of them that haven't quite survived the experience, and it's sort of to do with the recklessness maybe of some of the players that
you reckless child,
you know, sort of might have accidentally fallen into them or something like that. But to be honest with you, they are actually quite durable. We're super happy with them, and you know, we use them all the time. And yeah, I just wanted to sort of show you how easy it is to set them up. Can purchase them, once again, through Amazon. I've got the link in the description below if you wanted to get some of these. But even if you just sort of wanted them in your garden, like, you know, they're quite reasonably priced, really. Now, some people that want to play football at home, especially during sort of the lockdown that we've been going through, 2020 and into 2021, you might not just want a goal standing in your garden the whole time. So these can like really fold away and like be put into like a small space, and then bring them out when you want to use them. And obviously if you've got siblings, you can play 1v1s and stuff like that and work on like your skills to beat players and stuff like that. So for parents, it's quite easy to keep them packed away. And then for players, it's great for their development. And you can do loads of stuff like passing drills into them, finishing drills into them. We've used them in goalkeeping sessions before. Instead of having posts, we've got a bazooka goal and a bazooka goal. So the goalie's got to try and save it across the floor into the low dives. So yeah, I couldn't recommend them more, really. So they're pretty cool. So I'm just going to show you now how they sort of set up and how easy they are to set up as well. Let's get going. So here's the little review, and showing you how now to put together your bazooka goal. And I've got the old GoPro head cam for a closer look. Here we go. So basically, as you can see here, we've got the bazooka goal, and normally it comes with two straps here, which are which we don't tend to have on just for convenience. And you've got this one strap over here, which usually stays on because, well, it's attached. And then you've got this long strap here. So this buckle unclips, and then you just loosen it up underneath. And then it unclips over here. And then it unclips over here. And then that bit there comes off. All right, and then the neck is underneath this part here, which, as you can see, ours are a little bit dirty because we have maximum use. And then come up, they basically lift up and turn, all right, and then flip it around, lift it up, turn it, and then there's a little clip which is just here, as you can see, and it pops in. Now we've attached ours here just to keep the net in good condition, and that basically the frame of your goal. And then what happens is over here, this little part comes through, round, and clips on. This little part for extra security comes round and through, just like that. Flip it around, through, round on the Velcro, like so. Same with this bit here, comes in, through, and around. And the final part, just so it doesn't move too much there, you have your strap here, which comes under, clicks on, slide it along, like so, round the back, clips on, and then we just tighten it up here. That way, no, the other way. To this point, click it down, and bosh, you're done. Now these ones that we've got here are sort of custom for us. So you've got our Academy logo on the front there. And then you can obviously position it anywhere you want. Grab a ball, and there's your goal. So just to give it a little bit of a test, if I bring it away from the wall, like, you can hit these pretty hard and they just don't move. All right, so, you know, they can take quite a lot of power, and they don't really move too much, yeah? Because they're just a little bit weightier. And you see how quick it was there to obviously put together. And you know, we bought 10 of these, so we have loads of little pictures set up. You can buy one or two for your garden during lockdown, and then for us to sort of put it away, it's just a reverse process. I put it on its side, unclip, loosen it up, this bit off, down, this bit off, undo the Velcro, undo the little, I don't know what these clips are called, but I can't see, there it is, unclip that. Put it in the middle, Velcro, unclip this, put it in the middle. Now what we tend to do, just to sort of keep it together, we just link these up, just to try and look after it a little bit, put them together, and then just let the net drop down, click, done. Oh, that bit stood up for me already. Slides in, up, slide in, put it down, roll your net up into the little sleeve part, Velcro it over, Velcro it down, last part over here. Don't forget your strap, and like I said, they do give you other straps as well that can detach for them. Sometimes you might think, oh, if they're going to get lost, but we use ours every day, so we don't put them back on. We just have that one strap there. Give it a little bit of slack. Where is it? A little bit of slack there. Hook it on. Tighten it up. Now, and that's that done. Bosh. And that is that. That's the Bazooka Golf. So, like I said, I'll put the link in the description below where you can get one of these. £99 for one, which obviously I think is quite a reasonable price. And, you know, they're very durable, very sturdy. You get a couple of these for your garden during lockdown, or if, you know, use them for your coaching sessions with your kids, get them personalised, get your badge on the back. Very, very cool. Very lightweight, easy to pack away, easy to store, don't take up a lot of space, and you can get different sizes. So the one that we were just doing there is 120 by 75, which is good size goal, especially if you're gonna be doing small sided games. So Bazooka Goal, have a look. Description, like I said below, details in there. If you've liked this video, you found that the information on it really good, please like, subscribe, and click your reminders for upcoming stuff. But thanks for watching. Peace out, people.